Hey everybody, welcome back. My name is Mel, and today we're going to be starting a super exciting vlog, and that is a project that I said I was going to start at the first of the year and decided that I need to follow through on. Every quarter, preferably, I would like to do a TBR project where you guys picked off of my owned physical TBR, and I will link that video up here if you guys have not seen it yet and want to leave me a comment, and you picked a couple of books, a book, anything that you wanted, one comment, multiple comments, it didn't matter, of what you wanted me to read off of my physical owned TBR. And about once a quarter, I'm going to randomize those comments and pick 2 to 3 books that you guys picked and read those books in a vlog for you guys. I thought that would be a fun way to try to get some of the books that I'm not highly prioritizing off of my shelves and read, because some of these have been sitting here for literal years and there's no reason for it other than I just don't have a reason to pick them up, and so I need you to give me a reason why I should pick them up. So, have my phone, I have randomized some comments, and let's see what my TBR is going to consist of. So Caroline said Happy New Year. Thank you, Caroline. They said, my adult fantasy TBR is very similar to their own, so they would suggest Foundry Side and then either First Law or Powder Mage. So I've actually already started First Law, and then Powder Mage has been announced for the Backlist Book Club hosted by Cassidy. So that means we are going to be going with Foundry Side by Robert Jackson Bennett. This is a, I think it's classified as an adult fantasy, but I've also heard some people say that it is young adult, so I think it's on like the upper end of the young adult spectrum, and it is about a world, I think, where you can basically tell objects what you want them to do and make them do whatever you want. Certain people have this power and this ability, but I don't think everybody has it. I want to say there's a little bit of a heist in this story where our main character has to go steal an artifact, which turns out to be a key that can unlock anything, and that key talks. So we're gonna see. Hopefully I enjoy this. It has been on my TBR for forever. Like, you can't even buy the hardcover anymore. It's been so long, so if I love it, I may have a hard time getting the rest of the series in hardcover. But anyway, this is a completed trilogy, so I really, really need to get on it. Thank you so much, Caroline, for finally encouraging me to pick it up. And then I think I'm going to do 3 books for this video. So the next book that we have was picked by Tannins and Tales, and they said that I should read The Hypnotist by Lars Kepler. So this is a Nordic noir mystery. I've not read a lot of Nordic noir. I've read an Iceland, and then I have also read the first of the Joe Nesbø series, and I liked that pretty well. Nordic noir, I think, is a lot slower, more mystery, more focused on like the characters and the case kind of situation. This one doesn't look very long, but it's actually like 500 pages. No, almost 600 pages. So it is quite a long book, but I've had it for a while. I've been very interested in it. I kind of want to dip my toe into Nordic noir and see if it's something that I enjoy. And I think this is a good place to start. It is a series following Yuna, I think Yuna-Lina, who is the head of the National Crime Unit. He often demands to investigate murders. There is a surviving witness, a boy whose family was killed right in front of his eyes, and then he decides that he is going to enlist a hypnotist to help him interview the boy, because the boy is like too sick to basically be interviewed on his own, and so he's going to hypnotize him to try to remember what happened to his family. Obviously, things do not go as planned. So I'm interested in this one. I hope that it's good. We're gonna dip my toe in and see what I think. And then we have the lovely Emma. I'm so glad that Emma's comment came up, and she had several things for me to choose from. She said I could do Dragonflight, Polar Bear Explorers Club, A Storm of Sisters, or The Collarbound. Polar Bear Explorers Club and Storm of Sisters, I do need to read both of those. The Storm of Sisters actually completes the series, so I probably should have picked that one. I'm not really feeling the middle grade. It was between Dragonflight and The Collarbound, and if you guys watched Cassidy's BookTube Bestie videos, you'll know that she just gave The Collarbound 5 stars and really, really enjoyed the world building in this. A lot of the complaints for this book was that it felt like the prelude to an 800-page book, and that concerned me a little bit because we did not have any sequels announced until recently. And now she has officially said that I think this is going to be a trilogy, and the next book comes out in May, which is quite soon, so it's a perfect, perfect time for me to pick this up. I have the Goldsboro edition, which is really pretty. It's not very long at all, and it's oddly enough compared to R.F. Kuang's The Poppy War and The City of Brass. I don't really know a whole lot about this book. I know that it is about some refugees, And we have Isha, who is trying to fit in amongst other mages, but she has a tattoo that brands her as an outcast. And then we have Tatters, who wears the golden collar of a slave, which I'm assuming is where the collarbound title comes in from. And it says, as the rebellion carves a path of destruction toward the city, an unlikely friendship forms between a man trying to escape his past and a woman trying to uncover hers, until secrets threaten to tear them apart. I'm interested. I trust Emma. I trust Cassidy. I'm excited for this, so we're finally going to pick it up. Plus, I need to get some of the special edition or book boxes that I have read and off my shelf. So this fits perfectly for that. So this is my TBR for this video. I'm very excited about it. I think you guys picked some winners, and I'm excited to get started. I think I'm probably going to start with The Hypnotist. I don't know why. I'm feeling the mystery. So we're going to start here, and I will touch base with you guys once I've gotten a little bit further into it and have any semblance of thoughts whatsoever. But so wish me luck. We're going to clear some crap off my shelves. Video without a car update? No, I don't think that it is. So I wanted to let you guys know that I am about 25-30% into The Hypnotist by Lars Kepler. This is a Swedish book that has been translated into English. I believe it's a wife and husband duo, if I'm not mistaken, but don't quote me on that. It is following a detective in a case that he is working on where an entire family was murdered, except for the young boy was attacked and survived, but there was a daughter that apparently was not there and missing, and he's afraid that the daughter is going to be hunted down and killed. And then he's going to enlist a hypnotist into helping him interview the boy that has been severely injured. I'm liking it so far, but I'm also a little unsure. The writing style is very punchy and dry. It's, I think, because it is a translated work is why a lot of that is very like direct, distinct, period, sentence. It doesn't flow super well. But again, I'm assuming that a lot of that is because it is translated. And I like the direction that we're going, but Lars Kepler does have a tendency to kind of go off on tangents about things that don't really seem like they're going to matter. So I'm curious to see where it's going. I don't feel like it's at all what I expected so far. I'm intrigued, but I'm also slightly bored. See what happens. I'm definitely planning to continue. I also am a little irritated because Yuna is making all of these inferences, and I'm sorry, but one inference and you're correct, fine. But a million inferences that you're always right about and like you don't have any real thing to back them up, I don't know. It feels a little cop-out-ish that you're not giving him a reason why he thinks all of this stuff, and then he's correct because he's making good detective work, not just a hunch that just is always magically right. I don't know. We'll see. I'm having a decent time with it. I'm intrigued. I'm going to keep reading, and I'll check in with you guys probably a little over the 50% mark. Okay, guys, here to give you a non-car update on The Hypnotist by Lars Kepler. I was correct. This is a husband and wife author duo. I really want to be loving this, but I'm not. So Nordic noir is kind of known for being slow, giving you a lot of backstory on the characters, lots of red herrings, just like more of a true mystery, and I want to love it. I do, I promise. However, I'm not sure that it's going to be for me. I won't say I'm not a character-driven reader because I need good characters, but I also need things to be happening. And when you're telling me all of this stuff about characters that I don't really care about and is not relevant, like if it's relevant, that's great. But if it's not, like, I don't need to know what happened to them when they were 2 years old. That has absolutely no bearing on why they became the way that they are today. So I'm probably 70-ish% into this book. It is a whole heck of a lot longer than I thought it was. It's like 500 pages and forever and a million years long audiobook. But I'm finally chugging my way through it. So far, I'm mostly bored throughout the middle. Like, nothing was really happening. There are two cases that are being talked about. One where a young boy survived this like mass murder of his family, and then another where someone's son goes missing, and I'm gonna start to need those just connect soon, because if we just have two completely separate stories running alongside each other for no reason, I'm going to be so annoyed because we had this story at the beginning, or this case at the beginning, which was the boy surviving the attack. And then, like, we talk about that till about halfway, and then it's just for the last, I feel like, 20%, not mentioned it at all. And we go off on this tangent somewhere else in La La Land, and I'm just like, I don't understand. I want to like it. And the writing is fine. It's very dry, but I feel like that's intended, so I'm not going to dock the writing for being dry. The audiobook narrator is doing fine, but I just don't care. And you would think that me getting so much backstory into these characters, I would care a little bit more, but I don't. There's also so many, like, clinical sex scenes and discussions in this, and not in a good way, like in a gross, creepy, disgusting kind of way, that I'm just not here for. I don't mind a little smut. I don't mind clinical sex talk. Hello, work in medicine over here. It's really hard to gross me out, but it's just cringy, and I feel like completely unnecessary how focused they are. It's like the id in Sigmund Freud or whatever, where you're like super focused on sex. That's kind of how this book acts sometimes. Anyway, I feel like I am ranting. I don't hate this. I don't. But I don't like it either. So we're looking at like a high 2, low 3 at the moment. I will say that in the last few pages, well, I don't know how many pages because I'm listening to the audiobook, but I will say in the last little bit, it has started to pick up. More is happening. Things are going. There was a really weird scene involving a boy at a harbor that I quite enjoyed. So I'm curious to see where it goes. I know that Deb's review said that there were a lot of red herrings and she ended up really enjoying it, even though Nordic Noir is not her thing either. So I'm hopeful that the ending will turn this around for me. I still don't think it's possible for it to get more than a 3-star at this point, but I'm prepared to eat my words. So anyway, I've talked about this for way longer than I thought I would for this to be a second update, but I'm going to hopefully finish this. It might be tomorrow because I'm not sure that I'm in an audiobook listening mood tonight, so very possibly will be a tomorrow problem. We'll see. Also, let's talk about how floppy this book is. Like, even if I hate it, can I really get rid of that? Like, look at that flop. I'm gonna shut up now. I will talk to you guys later. Okay, everybody, so let's talk my final thoughts on The Hypnotist by Lars Kepler. This one, it ended up not really working that well for me. I don't hate that I read it. I'm glad that I read it. I'm still not sure if Nordic Noir is for me. I read The Joe Nesbo, didn't mind it, but this one, it just was not a favorite. I think it was just too long was a lot of my problem. I felt like it was meandering. The way that everything resolved just didn't really do it for me. So let's go through really quickly what I rated it. The characters, I'm gonna give a 6. I felt like for the amount of time that we spent in their backstories and trying to learn about them, they just never really felt that well fleshed out. Like, I never really felt like I knew the characters or their motivations or why they were making the decisions that they were making, because a lot of times those decisions just felt illogical and I just never felt the characters, main characters, side characters, it didn't really matter. None of them felt that fleshed out to me, and that was frustrating because we spent so much time learning about them. So it's not that they were inherently bad, and I don't think that's why I'm going to give them less than a 6, but I wouldn't say that they were groundbreaking or awesome either. For the setting, I also think I'm going to have to give this a 6. I expected it to be a lot more vivid of a setting. I feel like that's something that this type of story and genre would do really well. And there were moments where I was like, ooh, man, that punches. Like, that's a really good scene or a really good descriptor, but then it would just kind of start to lull again to where things were just being kind of blanketly described and I just never felt like I was fully in it or immersed, and that was kind of sad because I expected to really enjoy that aspect of this book. I think I'm going to give the writing a 7. I don't think it was poorly written. Like I said, it is very punchy, very dry. Part of that I think is coming from the translated aspect of it, and I don't know exactly how well it was written in Swedish. I only know how well the translator translated it, but it was fine. It was well written. It was, I won't say engaging, but it was not a bad read. I didn't feel like it didn't flow or make sense or anything like that. The plot, I think I'm also going to give a 6. I liked the plot with the hypnotist, but I also did not understand why the original case was even present, because it doesn't matter that much after the beginning of the story. It's more like a trampoline to get the rest of the story moving, and I just don't feel like you need to go into that much detail about it. when it wasn't going to matter. Like, either make it a bigger part of the story and make it connect a little bit better, or don't do it at all. And so for that, for me, it was a 6, because part of the story was fine. The rest of it felt completely pointless. And then for enjoyment, I think I'm going to give it a 6. It wasn't a complete meh, but there were a lot of things that frustrated me about this. I did, like I said, like the mystery aspect of it. I think that she did some of the, or they did some of the descriptions quite well, and some of the more, even slightly horrific. It was like, oh wait, that's a scene. I appreciated that scene, but there wasn't a lot of it. And so most of it, I was just kind of bored. Like I said, the latter half did speed up quite a bit, but I wanted a resolution that was different than what I got. I didn't feel like the plot was overly twisty. The red herrings just, they were there just to make them red herrings. And I don't like that. I like it when my story has red herrings in a way that you could figure it out, but you just don't, because there's all of these things and all of these ties. And I just don't feel like that was done very well here. Maybe I was expecting too much from it, but it ends up getting a 6.17, which is a low 3-star. That feels about right. I'm fine with it. So I have finished this one. I'm glad I read it. Will I continue in the series? I don't know. I guess let me know down in the comments if you think that I should, if this was one of the weaker books, because for me, the hypnotist aspect of the story was just not all that interesting, and from a medical standpoint, made no sense to me. Yuna was a bit of a self-righteous asshole, for lack of a better way to put it, and so we'll see. I don't know if I'll continue or not. I may just leave that as my foray into Lars Kepler. Leave it alone. Haven't decided yet. But next I'm going to be moving into Foundry Side. I left the book in the office and I'm too lazy to go get it. But I decided to do the audiobook for this one as well. I had to get it from Audible, which was aggravating. You would think it's been out a while, the audiobook would be easy to get, but it wasn't. This is about a girl who can touch objects and like hear them and learn more about them. And it's set in a system where with magic you can scribe on objects and get them to basically do whatever you want. And she's told that she will be paid a lot of money to steal this object. Turns out this object is a talking key that can unlock anything. I think that there's going to be a lot of humor in this, especially from the key, and we will see if I end up liking that or not. I have gotten like 10% in, so not very far, but I'm not sure how I'm going to feel about the humor. It also feels like this book should be written in first person. Maybe that's just because it kind of feels young adult-ish to me, and a lot of YA is written in first person, but I feel like it should be written in first person, but it's not. It's in third, and it's kind of throwing me off a little bit. I don't know what makes me feel that way, but I'm adjusting. It's gotten better as I was driving home. I was like, okay, I'm starting to settle into Robert Jackson Bennett's groove, and we'll see if that continues. But anyway, I've got the long drive to work tomorrow and the long drive home. I also don't have any patients tomorrow afternoon, so I'm hoping that I can get some reading done tomorrow afternoon. Just like shut my door and pretend the world doesn't exist. That sounds like a great idea. So we'll see. I'll let you guys know once I've read some more. But tonight I'm going to go jump on some sprints with Lexi and hopefully get some more reading done, because too many books, too little time. Okay guys, so time for another kind of like snotty update. I'm getting over being sick, but I am feeling better. So that's a step in the right direction. I think I had some kind of cold. The docs had it earlier this week and they just shared. So anyway, if I sound a little nasally, that's why. You may can hear the birds in the background. Ollie has demanded going outside and he is refusing to let me shut the door. So if you can hear birds in the background, I'm indoors. But that's why. I wanted to update you guys because I have now finished Foundry Side by Robert Jackson Bennett. And I know that you're thinking, Mel, didn't you just start that? Like, did I miss a 50% update? No, you didn't. I just forgot to update you. I was sick when I got to about the 50% mark, and I didn't want to sound absolutely terrible when coming on here to do this update. So I finished it, and now I'm going to update you. Overall, I had a fun time with this book. I don't think that it is anything groundbreaking. I don't think it's the best written thing I've ever experienced, but I did think that the world was really cool, and I liked the incorporation of physics into the magic system. I thought that that was a really interesting way of talking about the scribing and the way that the magic system worked. I liked that quite a lot. I liked our main character, and I liked our supporting key. But the other supporting characters I just could have done with or without. They all just kind of seemed a little one note to me. And while I did eventually like get very used to the writing style, I do think that it was very simplistic. It wasn't poorly written by any stretch of the imagination, but there are a lot of themes in here that could lean more adult, but I do think that the writing style lended itself in tone to more of a young adult, therefore making it a new adult type story. I think that for somebody that is looking to break into an epic fantasy with hard magic system and hard rules, this would be a really, really good entry point. It was a lot of fun and I enjoyed it. So for the characters, I think I'm going to give it a 7. Like I said, I enjoyed our main character and I enjoyed Clef quite a lot, but the supporting characters I do think could have been a little bit stronger. They all seem to have that whole getter kind of personality and not really a lot of nuance to them, but I thought that her character was well done. I liked her backstory and kind of how she ended up to be where she was, and her relationship with Clef was really entertaining and fun to watch grow. For the setting, I actually think I'm going to give it an 8. I quite liked the magic system in the Foundry Side setting. It's almost steampunk, but not really. It's a world where you can scribe onto objects and basically give them commands of things that you want them to do. And those commands can subvert reality, essentially. So, for example, you can tell a cart that it is rolling downhill, but it's on a flat surface, therefore it just rolls at a steady function forward. Some of these scribes got really, really complex, and it actually included some physics, and I enjoyed that quite a lot. I thought it was very, very well done, very well imagined, unique. I enjoyed it. Then for the writing, I think I'm going to give the writing a 7. Like I said, it was well written. It wasn't always my preferred writing style because it was very, very punchy, but I think it served the story well in the kind of lighthearted, sarcastic tone that this entire book took. So I think I'm going to have to give that one a 7. For plot, it's going to either be a 6.5 or a 7. I'm still trying to kind of decide because I feel like there was a little bit too much fluff in this story. We have a lot of heist situations where our main character is having to go steal something, and I just felt like that scene was repeated a few too many times. I would have liked something a little bit more, just a little bit different. I wanted her to have a different goal or to go about getting information in a different way rather than stealing it and having this heist scene over and over and over again. But at the same time, I quite enjoyed the heist plot. So I think that that's why it's going to lean probably more of a 6.5. It did get a little bit repetitive for me, but I enjoyed it while I was reading it. And then I think for enjoyment, it's either going to get a 6.5 or a 7. Probably leaning a little bit more toward a 7. I did quite enjoy this book. I can't find anything that I'm just like, okay, this is inherently bad. I really, really didn't like this. But I won't say that it's going to be my new favorite fantasy or anything of that nature. It was fun. I think it was well written. I think it had some really, really good ideas. And I think it's going to be a very good bridge book for people that are coming from the young adult, character-focused, relationship-focused type story into a more adult, magic system, rules-focused type story. Does that make sense? Like, I'm not saying young adult is bad. I'm just saying the focus is in different places. And so if you're looking to kind of get into that more world-building focus, then this may be a really good entry point for you. So overall, that gives it a 3-star. I had fun. I'm glad that I read this. I am so happy that I was finally talked into reading it because it's been on my TBR for forever in a million years and it was time. So I need to move on to The Collar Bound next, and I don't have an audiobook for that, so I will probably start it possibly tonight, possibly tomorrow. If I'm being completely honest with you guys, today is Monday. Monday are Kaylee Sprints, which I will probably participate in, but they're also Bachelor Day or night, and I shouldn't watch The Bachelor. It is like the worst trashy TV. There's so much better trashy TV out there, but it's a train wreck that I just can't look away from. So I probably will watch The Bachelor. Like, I'm this far in at this point. We're on week like 8. I think we may be going into overnights. I can't remember 100% yet. Or maybe it's hometowns. I think it's hometowns. Anyway, we're really far in and I'm committed at this point, so I might as well finish it. I don't care who wins. I would love for Charity to be the next Bachelorette, but that's all I got. So anyway, I'm going to go do that. And once I've read a little bit of Collar Bound, hopefully before I finish it, I will come back and check in with you guys. Oh, hi. Hello. It's been a while since I've talked to you for this vlog. I had gotten sidetracked with a couple of other different things, like Lexi's Patreon readathon kind of sidetracked me a little bit. The Ember Blade reading, if you guys have seen that, sidetracked me a little bit, but I'm back and reading The Collar Bound. I think I'm going to try taking this plastic off because it's really bothering me that it's glaring every time I get it into the ring light. So hang on a second. Mo better. Okay. So So I wanted to update you guys on the Collarbound. I'm really, really enjoying this so far. I did listen to the audiobook on the way to work this morning, and unfortunately, I don't think the audiobook is going to be the way to go for me in this book. The narrators are good. I think the male narrator is actually the same one that does The Witcher, if you guys have listened to that and enjoyed it. But while they are doing a good job, I do feel like this is the type of story that you really need to be able to fully process. And that's coming from somebody that reads a lot of high epic fantasy. It's told in a way where there are a lot of things that you're kind of just dropped in and learning about that I feel like are too easy for me to zone out while listening to the audiobook. There's also a companion of sorts. I don't want to say too much more because I don't want to spoil it, but there is a companion of sorts that interjects into the thoughts of another character. And I don't feel like that's being as well done audibly as listening or as reading it with my eyeballs. I feel like I'm missing that's the character that's speaking sometimes. And so when I picked up the physical book, I was like, oh wait, Whiplash, that was somebody else this whole time. The female point of view, I do really like. I think she's doing a good job. The narrators are both doing a fine job. I just feel like this is a story that is more easily digested in a physical format. With that being said, I also was struggling a little bit with the audio because it just kind of drives me crazy when there are two or three different narrators and they're either not all the same speed or not all the same volume. And so while I can listen to both of them on the same speed, the female's point of view is drastically louder than the male's point of view. And so for him, I was having to like crank it up and then it would flip over to her and I was like, ah, my ears, and had to crank it back down again. And that was really kind of getting on my nerves. But I am about 35-40% into this so far, and I'm really enjoying the world building. There are humans, there are mages, there are like used to be giants, and this is all revolving around a nest, essentially, which is a magic school for these mages. And then there's also these other creatures that have horns and tattoos that I'm really enjoying learning more about. The main magic system in this is something called mind linking, which I'm finding fascinating, and the things that you can do with it, like projecting feelings and all five senses into somebody's mind to make them truly believe something while also outwardly projecting from yourself. It's so cool and so interesting, and I'm loving it. I am waiting on it to find a point. So a lot of what we're doing so far is just learning, and I went into this expecting there to be a lot of learning about the world and setting up the world and setting up the characters and their backstories rather than a plot-driven book. So that's not really bothering me, but I am waiting to see where is the story going to go, because now we know that this is a trilogy, and I think The Hawking is supposed to be coming out in May, although I have not heard other than the title, and now it's showing up on Goodreads. I have not seen a cover. There's no blurb. The author hasn't really put anything out, so I'm not sure if it's actually coming out in May or not, because you would think by now we'd have a cover and a blurb considering it's a month away. But anyway, I'm assuming that with it being a trilogy, it is going to find direction, so I'm just waiting to see what that direction is going to be. I'm still having a great time with it. It's not really bothering me that it doesn't have a lot of direction, but I'm excited to find out what that's going to be. So having a great time with this so far, really, really enjoying it. Cannot wait to continue reading it. I actually want to pick it up, and considering the week that I've had and the fact that I'm so tired, I don't want to read when I get home. That's saying a lot for this book. So I'm going to go back to reading this, and hopefully I continue to love it as much as I currently am. I'm having a great time. Hi, hello, welcome back. I have just finished The Collarbound, and I wanted to tell you guys about it because this was such a huge success for me. I was slightly nervous because Cassidy loved it and said she didn't know if I was going to love it too, but she had high hopes, and I'm so, so, so happy to say that I thoroughly, thoroughly enjoyed this book. There were a few points more toward like the beginning of the second half that I did find we were doing a lot of talking, and while I was still very interested in the world and the world building, it was getting somewhat repetitive and I started to slowly lose interest. But then we got to the end and the ending was amazing. We found the footing that I was hoping that we would find, and I loved it. I thought that it was extremely well done. The world was really interesting. Again, I would recommend reading this physically, even though the narrators aren't bad. I do think that it absorbs better with your eyeballs. Thoroughly enjoyed this. It ended up getting an 8.92, which is 0.08 below a 5-star. So this is a very high 4-star. It just didn't quite reach the 5-star mark for me, but it was so stinking close that I'm half tempted to bump it up. But I think that I'm gonna leave it at the high 4-star for now. The weakest points for me were just the plot, because there really wasn't a lot of plot for the majority of the story. It's very, very heavily leaned into the world building and the writing and just my general intrigue. I still gave the plot an 8 because I thought that the plot that did come in and the little sprinkles of things that we got throughout the book were still really, really well done. It just did not quite have enough for what I'm used to in a high epic fantasy, but I still really enjoyed it. So I didn't want to knock it off too much for that. Characters got an 8.5. I thought that they were extremely well done. I enjoyed them thoroughly, but I definitely felt like I was engaging more with them as we went along. They got stronger as we went. And yeah, I'm so very pleased with this book. I'm so happy that I read it. Thank you, Emma, for picking this off of my own TBR for me to read, because it was a huge win and I'm so excited. It will be on some of my top most recommended books for people that love a really intricate, vivid world. This is not gonna work for those people that want like action, 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 action. Like this is not gonna be the book for you. And I don't even know that it will appeal to the super, super, super character driven readers. For me, the world was just so good and the characters were enough and the plot was enough that I was engaged anyway. But if that's your preferred style, just kind of have your expectations set when you go into this book. But highly, highly recommend. Definitely enjoyed. So I guess that we just need to wrap this vlog up then, because that was the last book on this vlog. I think that this was a pretty big success. I do want to continue to do these, absolutely. My goal is once every 3 months, but we'll see if I can keep that up. I would really love to do these at least once a quarter with 2 to 3 books each time so that I am consistently reading off of my own TBR instead of letting them just sit there in favor of the newer and shinier books. So I think this was definitely a win. Just to quickly go back through and remind you guys what I thought about these books and who picked them for me. The first one that I read was The Hypnotist, and this was chosen for me by Tannins and Tales. So thank you so very much. This one was not the biggest win, but not the biggest fail. It was just a little slow for me. I felt like the focus was in some weird places, but I'm intrigued to continue. I ended up giving this one a low 3-star, but I kind of want to continue with the series. So if you've read more books in the series and you maybe didn't enjoy the first book as much and think they get stronger, or think that I would like later books in the series, let me know, because I'm still kind of on the fence, but I'm leaning toward I would like to continue. So thank you so much for this recommendation. And then Caroline suggested Foundry Sci, because she said her taste and my taste and our shelves tended to line up pretty well. And I really enjoyed this one. It ended up being a middle to high 3-star for me. There were some issues that I had with it, but overall I thought that, again, this was one of those really, really strong worlds where the heist plot did get a little bit repetitive while interesting, and the characters I did enjoy but don't feel like they were the center, the star of the show, except for the key. I think the key was pretty cool. But the world definitely steals the show in this, and the magic system and how all of that is set up. It invites in like physics-based magic, and it's a hard magic system. I loved it. I thought it was super, super cool. So thank you so much to Caroline for recommending this one. I definitely think that this was a win. And then of course, last but not least, Collarbound, which you guys have heard me talk about. Emma told me to read it. Huge success. So honestly, we had a nearly 5-star, a high 3-star, and a 3-star. So I'm gonna consider this vlog a humongous success. Thank you guys so, so, so very much for helping me out with this video. I'm definitely planning to do another one of these this is March. Probably June. I need to get out of readathon season and then we'll do another one of these. So if you have not already gone and voted for books off of my own TBR that you want me to read, I will link the video down in the description box below, and that way you guys can go check it out. I have unhauled a few books since then, and so it's not completely updated, but it's pretty accurate. And don't worry about repeats. It just means that there's more likely the chance that a book will get picked. So please go vote on that if you have not already. The more comments, the better, the more I have to choose from. And thank you guys so very much for watching. If you are here and you just want to let me know that you hung out and you enjoyed the video, leave me a crown emoji. I don't know why. I just think that a crown emoji is fitting. So leave me a crown emoji if you were here and you just want to let me know that you enjoyed the video. Sorry guys, my dog was like doing some kind of weird coughing thing. Anyway, as always, links to my Instagram, Patreon, Twitter, and Goodreads are all down in the description box below. If you enjoyed this video, please give it a big thumbs up and subscribe if you want to. And I will see you guys in the next one. Bye.